Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. It's about 8:30 a.m. on day 5, and we've already done quite a bit and learned quite a bit. We know that we need a heart from a highly infected person. We need a freshly cut out heart that can't be more than 30 minutes old to deliver to Reuben to help with vaccine research. And to get that heart, we need Isidore Brock's son's help. And unfortunately, young Isidore has been arrested and is currently sitting in Town Hall, along with many other people, just people in general that have been unfairly arrested by Sabarov. So our main quest is to get the heart for Reuben, but our side quest right now is also to help out the other people that have been imprisoned unfairly. And we also have a letter from Anna Angel. She has a bit of a proposal for us. So next, the first thing I'm going to do now is talk to Sabarov. See if I can convince him to perhaps release Isidore Barak's son. And maybe the other people, too, that have been unfairly arrested. So let's go speak with him. I feel like I've got plenty of time for the day, so I'm feeling pretty good. It's 8:30 in the morning, and I already know what I need to do for the day. Just want to check on my ammo. 6, 7, 8, so I've got 8 shots in total. 6 in my gun, 2 sitting out here. Why are there still guards here? This place is not infected. The infected areas are strictly off-limits. But it's not infected. It's just intensely yellow. Huh. This area over here, however, is infected. Oh, they're beating up a bad guy. I'm gonna watch. Oh god, no! Not a plague rat! Fuck you! You're not worth the ammo. Or are you? I think I can loot that body fast enough. Nothing on the body, okay. Keep going. You've been defeated by terrible pathfinding. Oh, right, you're not Alexander. Wrong side.
Only in things of small value, they usually are bold enough not to trust to appearances. The wheel of my fortune. Does anything help with the disease?
Okay, Sabarov. We need to have a big chat.
That's okay, I'll make it. I'm made of wood.
We did really well last night. Sir, a lot of innocent people were falsely accused yesterday. I demand you set them free. Who told you they were innocent? They were arrested on suspicion of robberies, murders, and thefts. Who made the charges? People I trust as much as myself. The patrolman who selflessly served to maintain order and keep townsfolk safe from violence caused by that out-of-control scum. That is something new. So now arrests, trials, and executions are all carried out by the same people? There are good reasons for the accusations. The patrolman didn't file individual reports, but each one of them is ready to answer with their life for their actions. Those who were arrested deserved it. Prove it, then. There's this thing called the presumption of innocence. Is it no more one of the basics of criminal law? Not since a state of emergency was declared in the town. As you can see, I've executed no one. All of them are waiting for the Inquisitor's trial. You've made people angry. It was hard enough for them to keep from violence when the situation prompted them to. Now they're furious, since their virtuous restraint was penalized rather than appreciated. We can't take any chances. We have to catch every suspicious-looking person, in order to avoid further murders. If you keep doing it the way you do it now, mark my words, you won't prevent further murders. You'll cause them. I guess you feel obliged to be a humanist, Bachelor. Do you really think the arrests will provoke the people? Don't. We're past fearing popular unrest. The most terrible things have already happened. It can't get any worse. Yes, it can. I'm not a humanist. I don't care much about those people's sorrows. But what you've been doing here is suicidal. I'm telling you this because I care about what will happen in the streets tomorrow. That's it? He's not gonna do a damn thing. God damn it.
What has this town turned into? Truly a country of contradictions. The hunchback usurer is looking for those ready to join Razormen. That is dangerous. The rabble is completely out of control. They must have been bottling up their lowly instincts for quite some time.
That's it. That's all he's gonna do. He's not even gonna release young Barak. Alright then. Let's go. Let's go see what Anna Angel's offer is. She sent me that letter. And I believe, with what I talked to Bad Grief about, it sounds like Anna wants to actually pay to have Bad Grief's people released, and then she wants them to be under her thumb, under her control. It seems like a dangerous game to play. How am I doing on food? Hunger, moderate. Yeah, let's buy some food. Vegetables would be nice. Let's just leave it at vegetables. Vegetables? What did I just say? Vegetables. 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 There we go. Hunger's at about 40%. And also, since it's been a while, I want to take a stop at Andre Stomatin's pub. Somebody told me, and obviously it's true, that at the pub you can buy coffee, which you can use just like lemon, to lower your exhaustion. But I've still got one lemon left, so I don't think I need to buy that. Could buy the flour as barter goods. In fact, I feel like all of this stuff would be worth it to buy, because I think it's more useful as barter goods than it is to sell to people. And it's really cheap. But I am limited for space. Unless this... Can I just buy it anyway and it'll just, like, add to my inventory and scroll down more? Maybe my inventory is unlimited. Let's see. Maybe it is unlimited. It does scroll. I think I'll leave the bone necklace, though. It's a little bit pricier.
I've had my share of dancing. The curtain falls.
Nothing to say. Just doing the rounds.
How's my brother? Any news on him?
Yes. He is doing beautifully. Who's your brother again? I forgot.
What?
Actually, I believe his brother is on my list of adherents, right? Yeah, Andre Stamaton is the guy I just talked to. Peter Stamaton. Oh, that's the artist guy, right? I think so. I haven't seen him in ages. Can I talk to you? Nope. The children are finally here! Oh, never have I been so happy to see children. I have so many things to trade you. I really don't need antibiotics right now, but then again, it wouldn't hurt to stock up. Yeah, what the heck. Oh, and somebody told me that on one of the future days, I think it was day 7, they said there's an opportunity to get a free rifle, so it might actually be worth stocking up on rifle ammo before that day. So, you know what? What the heck? Let's do it. Okay, Anna, what is your offer? What are you planning?
Purr, says the cat.
Nya, says the cat. Alright, I have a plan. I know how to protect myself from future harassment, so that they wouldn't ever dare treat me like they did yesterday. What with all the terrible tests. I'll bribe my way out of this. Bribe my haters away. Ogimski is greedy, and he could very well use some money now. Even if it's true, are you really wealthy enough to bribe Ogimski? I'm totally broke right now, but I know how to fix this. Will you help me? We'll split the gain. What? Do you have a hidden treasure map or something? It's a treasure, all right, but a tricky one, too. It's attainable, but it wouldn't yield to me. That's why I need your help, yours specifically, since I know that you are to be trusted. Go ahead, then. Tell me. You must be aware that I'm an outsider, too, just like you. I came here a few years ago and stayed. For the fancy opportunities this place provides. What fancy opportunities? You're lying. You've stayed because the Ace of Diamonds caravan had been seized and dismantled. What? That sounds correct, so I'm gonna go with it, but, huh? Yes, the Ace of Diamonds caravan has been seized and dismantled. You liar. Is that really your business? The caravan creeps me out. It's worse than cannibalism. What is the caravan? I don't know what that is. I feel like I'm supposed to know something that I don't. Keep talking. Well, I didn't travel alone. I had a companion. He was a snake charmer. When the caravan persecutions and arrests started, his back was broken with an iron bar. So he's a usurer now? A spider of a usurer, weaving a net of debtors. He must have amassed a ridiculous fortune. Imagine how much there is to be extorted. What does it have to do with me? He's your companion. He's yours to exploit. You can tell him you've stumbled upon his past. We've been covering for each other, up until now. But the caravan is somehow becoming hot news again. The Canes will bury us alive when they hear about it. Unless the children themselves get to us first. The children themselves, are you serious? Surely you know that the children of this town possess the means to do great harm. Take Capella, for one. Or the bloodthirsty Khan. Or Notkin's soul in halves, who can easily set their dogs upon us. Oh, I'd serve the Sabarov simply because they do not have a privileged offspring with a gang of fellow fanatics. If you're partners, why don't you ask him to help you out voluntarily? You're planning to bribe the people that threaten you, after all. He will likely share your woes. He's got the same in store for him, too. You're right. Sooner or later, he'll face the same situation. But he wouldn't spare me a single coin. No way. That's because he knows your real background, too, so it wouldn't be too hard for him to get even with you, right? Do you need money or don't you? You can demand $100,000 from him. He'll shell out as much as you want him to. And you'll get half the sum if you stop asking pointless questions. This sounds too damn good to be true. Alright, show me where he lives. Here lives the hunchback who turned out to be Anna's accomplice from her caravan times. Is his just an accomplice? What? Who knows what kind of relationship those two had? That really seems too good to be true. Just go threaten him and he's just gonna give me a fortune?
I used to sing every evening. Purr, says the cat. I have this flush. My cheeks are burning, aren't they?
Okay, I've got a bit of a decision to make now. Where do I go next? I mean, it seems like what I need to do for the main quest. The vaccine is, Brock is somewhere in the works. There are quite a few separate workshops there. With all the information I've collected, finding him shouldn't be that much trouble. But just like I didn't understand where the works are and where I'm supposed to find him in the last episode, I still don't understand exactly where he's supposed to be. In fact, I even went over the last video and just replayed my conversation with Lara Ravel to try to figure out if I just missed something, and she really does make it clear where Brock is. Where his secret workshop is. But not really. She does mention that Brock was caught around the railroad crossing, the one that goes across the water, and that Brock also complained about having to go up and down the embankment all the time. So that makes me think the embankment must be this, right? The train tracks? The embankment of the train tracks? And I'm guessing the works is probably the warehouses, because that seems to be where that seems to be where Reuben works out of. And it is near the train crossing. And you would have to cross the embankment to get there. So I think it's here? I think this is the works? If it's not, I'm screwed, because I'm going to be wandering around this plague-infected place, probably getting more infected. Maybe fighting off plague rats and stuff. And if that's not actually where he is, then I'm pretty well screwed. And maybe that's not it. Where could the works be? I mean, as far as I'm concerned, this is all general housing except for this area. This is like workshops, this is industrial rooms. This is like warehouses here too, kind of. Could be here, I guess. I doubt it. I don't really know. I might waste a lot of time searching for him, but the thing is, I have to do it. It's part of the main quest, so I can't ignore it. I think maybe I'm supposed to go to the jail as well, and maybe speak to the people that are actually there. And that is pretty close, so maybe I should just go do that. Let's do it. I don't know, I'm pretty confused about this day. I feel like I've got plenty of time, but I'm pretty confused because I didn't understand the whole thing with Lara Ravel telling me where Brock is supposed to be. And I thought Brock was at the jail, so why does it say that Brock is somewhere in the works? I don't get it. I already bought food from you. I want more food. Let's go visit the jail, crammed full of people in the middle of an infected district. What a great idea. Oh, I see you, plague rat, you little bastard. I'm not going around. I'll shoot you. Seven shots left. I'm getting low. Could there be house ninjas here? Yep, house ninjas. Oh, you're stuck. That's not the blade. Here we go. Okay, you know what? Actually, this is too dangerous. I don't think it's worth it. Hello? I thought there's supposed to be people in jail. Oh. There they are. It's here. The sand plague is already in the left wing. We're working our beaks to the bone, taking the dead out. But the hungry jaws of the sand pest are rustling. Let the uninfected out, quickly. It's futile. Although, half an hour ago, a certain kind of person provided us with a display of true goodwill and compassion. He'd bought out several dozen people. Who was that? He looked remarkably shady. Dressed in a special overall and a beak mask. The nerve. How can you tell anyone's features in such clothes? What? You mean... like you, sort of? I mean, that's not a beak, though, right? Isn't that supposed to be a talon? The head? Was it bad grief? I don't know. I'm going to buy out the rest. Get the cash on the nail. Even if Sabarov refuses to take your money, we won't. We're not the scrupulous type. 10,000 per person! 60,000 for the whole batch. Jesus Christ, I don't have that much. We don't know for sure if those people are truly innocent. What if there are thieves, murderers, or looters among them? What if we let an unspeakable villain out? The price includes the risk-taking. Can't you tell a murderer from an honest person? Of course we can't. It's not like the patrol goons cared about the paperwork when they were collaring these poor souls. Who are they? What have they done to deserve this treatment? Hell, if anyone knows now. Forget the poor wretches. Let it go. Unlike us, you can do it for free. There's only a handful of convicts left in there anyway. You're one corrupt asshole. What a way to end the conversation. $60,000. That is so freaking expensive. If I had $60,000, like... I'm sorry, I'm probably gonna keep it. But if I got a massive sum from the Hunchback, perhaps... Let's go do that. Let's go visit the Hunchback. Oh, let's also see if we can get some more food. Just milk. Kid! Child, come here! Yes, drugs. There we go. 3 Meridorm. 1 Alpha Tablets. How's my immunity? It's pretty low, actually. Let's take the Alpha Tablets. There we go, maxed it out. This is the place. Hello? Probably shouldn't steal from this person, or they might hate me. There you are. There, gotcha. The man to do the job. Help me, kind sir. Save my poor soul. You're walking all around the town, don't you? Your line of work demanding it and all that? Right? Please find my daughter. My little darling thing hasn't come home today. Oh God. I'm supposed to extort money from this guy. The man to do the job? Do we even know who I am? Nay, I don't. I've been living here all secluded. Haven't been outdoors for almost a year. A year. Yeah. What happened to your daughter? She must have left at dawn, and she's still not back. I went to sleep and slept like a log. The twirine haze does that to you. And by my side was the pretty thing sleeping. In the morning, I woke up to find her gone. Neighbors didn't see a thing, them blind bats. I'd give you anything. I'm rich. Want to get 100,000? 150. Holy crap, seriously? If I can help this guy get his daughter back and he'll give me a vast sum, I would totally do that. That's so much better than trying to blackmail the guy. 200. Fine, 200 it is. Just bring her back to me. How do I recognize her? Name's Willow. She's 17. Dark wavy hair and the beauty of a very, very beautiful girl. No distinctive marks, though. She's a lovely singer and dancer. Now is not a good time for singing and dancing, though, so I don't know. Why do I feel like I've seen a Willow before? Have I? Let me write down these details, because I'm not gonna assume the game is going to write them down for me. So just in case. 17. Dark wavy hair. beautiful. Is Willow the person that I found out in the train car? Maybe. Where should I go looking for her? I don't know. Everywhere. She might be in an infected district. Or maybe not. What if she was murdered? Slaughtered? Seized by the patrol morons and thrown into jail? I've been to the town hall, though. No sign of my little girl. Shit. Well, I can still threaten him for the money. Ah, but this would be so much better if I could do this. Alright, I'll try, though I must tell I don't feel like I'm likely to succeed. Here, have some money. In advance. I've got more where it came from. This is criminal money, illicit money, earned through bad doing. It's time it served a good purpose. Those thugs, those robbers. I've always hated them. Even Nina couldn't take my daughter away from me. How can this be happening now, huh? After all those years of having her here. This person is very strange. I can tell him that he's disturbing, and I don't think I'll bring the girl back to you. But... no, I don't know nearly enough about the situation to go to that extreme. Wait for me here. Oh my god. He just gave me 100,000, didn't he? Or is that 10,000? Oh, it's 10,000, okay. Still, 21,000 is a lot of money. I can't spare the time to just go looking literally everywhere, like, I just can't. She might be the one I saw in the train car. Here. I feel like that was maybe her. Maybe. I don't remember. I'm gonna take a chance and say that that is Willow. Just checking around, make sure. I feel like I've seen that name before. Just want to make sure it's not mentioned at one of these other places. Yeah, I think this might be Willow. I think that might be Willow. I'm gonna go there. I'm gonna take a chance. I got quite a bit of time left. It's not even 11 o'clock. And it's also gonna put me down around a good place to go across the train tracks and start searching for Barak's place. More drugs. Suppose I could take a stop by Baby Vlad's place. He's along the way, might as well. Ah, finally some more pistol ammo. Or revolver ammo, rather. And I think there's some new dialogue with her. Have you been crying? Our family is ruined. What happened? Do not eat meat. It was banned for a reason. I think meat is precisely where the disease is nesting. It must have all started with someone stuffing themselves full of infected meat. That's why everyone was blaming a man-eater, too. It all makes sense now. What made you think of that? Dad and other men attacked the guards yesterday and pried a meat storage open. The meat was then distributed among our neighborhood. Then almost all of them fell sick. And I'm so afraid Mom and I will fall sick and die, too. How long ago did you eat the meat? I don't really remember. 5 hours or so, I think. then it'll be okay, I think. If you were sick, you'd have noticed it already. Yeah, you'll be fine. Probably. By the way, what day was the train full of supplies supposed to arrive? Was it on day two that they said? Yes, we expect the train to arrive in 4 days, and that was on day two. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh! So it should arrive on day six. And it's day five right now. So tomorrow the train should arrive. Interesting.
Why is no one being buried?
Being locked up in jail equals being sent to the gallows in the current situation. Both spell imminent death. The executors demand 10,000 per person. 20,000 is the best I can do. Hopefully this will restore at least a shred of the lost faith in authority. It's a very lump sum, thank you. Wow. I wasn't expecting money from him. Do I have the updated map for today?
What?
Yep, looks like it. Wow, just gave me 20,000. I've got 40,000. I never thought I'd have this much money. Hope that this is actually Willow out here. Because if not, then I have no freaking clue. I know I've seen the name before. I know it. Willow, 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 Willow. She's supposed to be 17, though, right? What's the... I swear the person that I met over here was a little girl. I don't think she was 17. Dark wavy hair, beautiful. I mean, I think the woman dancing at Andre Stamaton's pub has dark hair, and she's beautiful. That could be her, I guess. She looks older than 17, though. And there's another person with the exact same character model that's at Bad Grief's lair. I guess that could maybe be her, too. Yeah, you do not look 17.
Your stuffing is coming out.
Nope, that is definitely not Willow.
What have you got there?
Oh, crap, I cut her off.
I'm damp and washed out.
Why do I feel like I know the name Willow? Like I've encountered somebody with that exact name. I swear I'm gonna find her and just, like, hit myself in the head, just thinking, God, it was that person all along, how did I forget? Alright, why don't we go to Bad Grief's lair? Maybe the woman in there is her. The one who I felt like I should have been able to talk to, but I never could. Yeah, maybe that's her. Thank you. If it's not, though, I could very easily waste way too much time on this quest. Gotta be careful with how much time I give to this. Please tell me you're Willow. Ah, it must not be. I can't talk to you. Shit.
Where are they taking the stiffs? Throwing into the river once again to drown the town?
Well, shit. Well, much as I hate to end the episode here, I know if I don't, this episode is going to go on for a really long time, because I'm not going to feel satisfied until I find either Willow or Brock's place, or perhaps both. So I think I'm going to save that for next time. I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to resume my ever more feverish search for Willow and Brock.